Can we start?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So good afternoon to all of you. Today we are going to start one important this topic, that is how to prepare digital content sitting at your home. Right now this is of immense importance, considering the fact that most of these teaching learning activities you have to continue through digital platforms, and agile methods of preparing digital content using available different tools and techniques, these are now of paramount importance. So therefore, we have planned to start a session on this particular topic, where we'll be demonstrating how different tools and techniques can be used for preparation of this digital content, you sitting at your home and using the all common gadgets and using only many open source softwares and very available, mostly available tools and techniques, not much expensive and easily available. So this is, I believe that many of you know many things regarding preparation of the digital content, but still we thought that it is one of our responsibility or one of our duty to make all our learning community aware of these different things which are quite useful for preparation of this digital content. So those who know many things, for them maybe it will be refreshing their knowledge. Those who do not know, for them it will be an opportunity for learning something new. But afterwards, my advice is kindly practice all these things and try to engage yourselves in preparing this digital content in the most attractive manner to keep your learning community, to keep your audience engaged. This is very, very important right now, because in digital platforms, the interest for taking this learning, or interest of being present before the screen for a long time to listen to the lecturers, that is very rapidly dropping. And for that, we need to experiment in many ways how to keep the attention level of our learning community active and engaged. So that's why this is one of our experiment. Kindly be a part of it. If you have something interesting to share with us, kindly share in chat box. And afterwards, if you have something more novel and more useful and fascinating things to share, we'll be very open and we'll be ready to use your experience and expertise in these platforms. But kindly let us attend these programs to see what we can offer. And after that, if you have something more to share, then let us know. We'll be using your experience, expertise in this particular area. So with this, I'd like to conclude right now, but I'll be here and I'm requesting Prithimoy to start the session. And in between, if you have any discussion, if you need any discuss any point, or if you want to validate certain points, kindly do not hesitate to interact. And I would like to make this session very, very lively, interactive, for the benefit of all our learning community present over here. So thank you. Prithimoy, start the session, and Prem Kumar, you can take the questions in between also.
So thank you, sir. So honorable Vice Chancellor, sir, and other respected faculty members. From the participant list, still it is growing. I see that more or less 311 participants are there, and some of them coming from different parts of India. So really, I actually welcome all of you to this workshop. Before we start, I just share the screen. Am I audible? Prem?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So before we start, I just shared my screen. Yes. So today, this is the online workshop on simple tools and techniques for preparation of digital content. Perhaps you understand what is the utility of this type of workshop in this pandemic situation. Because you know the school, college, university, all are closed now, and but the our learning process is still going on. So what we can do, we can develop the different types of digital lectures with the help of different types of techniques that is freely available, as actually already said by our Honorable Vice Chancellor, sir. So we mainly concentrate on how to develop the digital lecture by using the different types of open source and open source technology, okay, and free technology. So first of all, I tell you that there is a basic difference between the classroom lectures and the digital lectures, because I think that they are actually situated in two different poles. For example, in case of the digital lectures or in case of class lectures, you know that you can directly interact with students, but in digital lecture, you actually present virtually in front of the student through your computer, through his laptop or through his mobile. This is the first thing that is very important point. And second one is, of course, in case of classroom lecture, you know that the duration is maximum 40 to 45 minutes. And you can inspect what the actual student is doing. You can interact directly with them. But in case of digital lecture, it is tedious to students to concentrate on 45 or more minutes digital lectures in front of the machine, but because you are not there, only student see the screen in front of him. So it is too difficult to concentrate. And what's the issue that we actually tell you, that recently it is noted, one of the research work, actually I got the information from one of the research work, that we can concentrate on the screen of computer, in front of the computer screen, maximum 10 to 15 minutes. After that, what is going on, we are least bothered, because our brain is not able to understand what is going on. Therefore, you see that in previous CCTV system, what was going on, the CCTV simply captured the information and sent the information to the terminal, and in front of the terminal, one person will be there, and he actually inspect what is going on. But after 15 to 20 minutes, what is going on is simply ignored. Because it is not his fault, it is the fault of our nervous system. So you see that in if you see the different types of digital lectures of different university all over the world, you see that the maximum duration of the digital lecture is 10 to 15 minutes. Okay, if you see that in Coursera or edX, you see that or Udemy, you see that the maximum length of the lectures is maximum 8 to 10 minutes. Okay, and there are different types of applications actually incorporated in the digital lecture, so that the person who actually sitting in front of the machine and listen the lectures can directly interact with the lectures. He can understand that someone is there in front of him, like you. So today I actually give the lectures, I give the details of in this workshop, how we can prepare this type of lectures. And what's the tools and techniques, okay? Now, before that, this is the important thing that I want to share with you. I have already explained that in case of digital lecture, what's the problem, what's the, because you know that each and every initiative, there is some pros and cons. In case of advantage of the digital lecture, I have already explained, but what's the problem or what's the limitations of the digital lecture is that you have to create the lecture, not like a class lecture. You have to develop the lecture in such a way that the student can concentrate and student can really enjoy what you want to say, what your content of your lectures. So this is not a very simple task. So before you prepare the lectures, you just concentrate or you just remember following 3 points. First one is that all video lectures make it short. It is very much important. I have already explained. So if you think that your lectures is maximum 40 minutes, so you just break the lecture into 4 parts, 10 minutes each. Okay. Because I explained here that firstly break all the lessons into segments for nearly 10 minutes, maximum 10 minutes. Remember, every part of the lesson will be covered. So if you see, if you think that my lecture is 40 minutes, you just segregate into the lectures into 4 parts, 10 minutes, 10 minutes, 10 minutes, 10 minutes. And you just first create a lesson plan, just blueprint how you will proceed, and then you will develop the lectures. And after that, this is a very important point, quickly revisit what they may not have understood and give meaningful information. Because whenever we give the digital lectures, we least bother who actually present in front of me. Because when I give the lectures, I have only the machines. I have only my laptop, I have only my desktop or tab or mobile, etc. etc. So I am not able to understand what I am saying. Because they are in classroom lectures, what's the problem? Student can raise their hands. Because in classroom lectures, some students are actually they are developed and they are they know everything, but some are the backbenchers who are not able to understand what you are saying. But in case of digital lectures, you cannot segregate the student in such a way. These are the advanced students, these are the backbenchers. So you think that whenever you prepare the digital lecture, you think that your lecture should be in such a way, in such a manner that each and every student can understand. And if any queries or any doubts are there, you have to remember. And whenever you give the lecture, you mention or you actually incorporate one approach here so that the student who are not able to understand, they can ask directly with you. In this way, the student can understand virtually, you will present in front of them. So this is the first point, very much important. Second point is use image and animations in your presentation. Because if you see that, because nowadays you know that there are different universities are there, different sources are there where you get a lot of digital lectures. You see that whenever they shoot the video, they actually use different camera and different angles. Because continuously, if the students see the single face in front of a screen, actually, again, they are not able to concentrate. So you change. You see that in case of Coursera, in case of Udemy, in case of any digital lectures, you see, they actually captures the screen in different angle. Okay, this is the first thing, and you can use multiple camera. How I will later I will discuss. Second thing is that you also incorporate number of images or animations in your presentation. So that your presentation or digital lecture should be attractive. So student can concentrate, student can understand what you want to say. So this is the second thing. And third one is add or embedded the question directly into lectures. It's very common in case of Coursera and edX. Sometimes you see that when someone gives the lectures, and then if the lecture maximum limit is 10 minutes, then after 3 minutes, they actually give a question. That question actually appears on the screen. You have to give the answer, otherwise you are not able to proceed. Okay, and this question answer is the interactive way, so that where you give the answer, you see if it is wrong, then that pop-up message actually appears on the screen. You see that there is some problem in your answer, or you not giving the right answer. So again, you rectify your answer and understand what the actual answer of the question. Now you can able to proceed further. So in your lecture, you can also incorporate this type of questions in your lecture so that the student can understand what you are saying, and you can also understand what student actually understand and they also understand what you are saying or what you teach. They also understand. So there are a lot of softwares are there. You can go through that software. You can note down the software. For example, LearnWorlds. This is an effective software by which you can incorporate the question in your lectures, in your video lectures. Okay, even you can give some option in priority basis where you want to incorporate after 3 seconds or after 3 minutes or after 4 minutes, etc. and etc. You can segregate your lectures virtually into 3 to 4 parts, and you can embed the questions along with the answer in your lectures. So before you develop your digital content, you have to remember these 3 points. And now I explain, this is the control flow of my lectures. First one is the important thing, hardware for audio and video, because you know that whenever you prepare the lectures, video lectures, the video lecture mainly consists of 2 things, audio and video. Very important part, both audio and video are the very important part. And next, the part is the download YouTube video. Suppose you can actually shoot or you can record your video through your mobile or through your camera and et cetera, et cetera. But sometimes you can also incorporate some free YouTube video in your lecture. So your lecture becomes attractive to the students. So how it's possible without using the YouTube downloader, because you know the YouTube downloader is a third party software. So whenever you use some information may be stolen or you get some redundant information. So better you can use without using of any third party software, you can download. How I will explain. Next one is the segregation of video and audio. This is the important part. You, after you shoot the video or after you download the YouTube video, then you segregate the two component, main component, video and audio part. Because we can manipulate the video, we can enhance the quality of the video, we can enhance the quality of audio, we can incorporate different medium or different sound into our audio, and then we can again reconstruct the video. Okay, so how it's possible, I will explain in this section. Then handling video file with free Movie Maker software. You know, in Windows version, Windows Movie Maker is there, but now in Windows 10, it is not available. And Windows Movie Maker is not very effective software, that now you can use this Minitool Movie Maker software, which is freely available. And how you can use, I will show you in this section. Then the important part, handling audio file with Audacity. Audacity is an open source software actually used all over the world. And you can do a lot of things with Audacity. Today in a single session, it is too difficult to explain all these things, because if with the help of Audacity, you can develop your own digital studio, because this Audacity, and another thing is that in Audacity, the strong community is there. What type of problem you face, you can directly upload that information to Audacity, and the Audacity community will get the answer. Even from YouTube, you get a lot of information of Audacity. So I will explain about this software. This is open source, freely available software. Now the important part is the reconstruct of the video again. That means after you modify the your video, incorporate some things into your video and modify the audio, enhance the audio quality, incorporate something, then you can reconstruct the video again. And you can upload that video into the YouTube, or you can stream the video, okay. Then working with Microsoft PowerPoint for reconstructing video. This is very important point, because sometimes you see in news channel, some message actually appears on the top left corner, or some icons actually appears at the top right corner, et cetera, et cetera. If you want to incorporate some logo for your university, for your college, of your college at the top right corner of the slide or the video, it's not possible to incorporate that type of icon or logo with the help of Minitool Movie Maker, that type of open source software, because you can analyze the video file with the help of Minitool Movie Maker, but you are not able to incorporate the logo or icon, etc., etc., at the on your video, but with the help of Microsoft PowerPoint, we can embed, we can put your logo, we can put some things on your video with the help of Microsoft PowerPoint. I will explain here. Then working with Otter for transcription, you know that in modern day, what the digital content you see, that if someone actually tells something, automatically the transcription appears at the bottom of the lectures. For example, in Coursera, you see that what the expert actually is saying, that content, that transcription actually appears bottom of this video. Okay, so there are a lot of softwares are there. For example, Google's also there, but there are some difficulties or some problem by using of this type of software, because some credit card information, other information should be required for giving that type of information for using this the software. But here I explain the software Otter, which can use for transcription process very effectively, and the error rate is very minimum. Okay, I will show you how you can use the Otter software. Then working with graphics, this is a very important point, working with graphics, how I can incorporate the graphics tools in my lectures. I can simulate the classroom. I will show you how I can simulate. I can simulate teacher student in my presentation, so that the whenever you develop this type of lecture, student actually this lecture may be funny and student can interact with the lecture. They can see that this is the interaction with the teacher. So you can simulate this type of environment with the help of graphics. This is also a free software. I will explain. And at last, this is very much important. If you want to broadcast your video lively, for example, if you want to broadcast through the Facebook or YouTube, you can use the broadcast software, so that your computer, your laptop acts as a studio, digital studio. So OBS is one type of freely available software you can use for broadcasting. Okay, so this is the control flow of my lectures. Now I explain one by one. Before that, I just request you, as this is a workshop, so what you can do whenever I give the lecture, because I am not willing to give lecture in simplex mode. I give and you listen. And after ending my lectures, whenever you try to do something, you face a problem and nobody is there, then there is this is not effective. So what you can do, whenever you give the lecture, you also take your computer. You can do. You can download. You can try to do that. And if any problem arises, you can directly ask me. You can raise your hand. Frame is there. So if some questions actually appears, or some question actually you give, you send us some question, then I will give the answer. Okay. This will be interactive way. Interactive way, we can understand, we can just learn how to develop the system, overall system. Now, before we start, I explain what's the minimum requirement of the computer hardware and software. This is the important part. I know that I have to develop some attractive video, attractive lectures, but my computer is able to do that. This is the first question. So what's the minimum requirement? Whatever I actually did in the preparation of my site, I think that Windows is the user-friendly software. So I think that each and everyone use the Windows, not Linux, because in case of Linux operating system, you know, some system programming knowledge should be required, but in case of Windows, is a user-friendly software, user-friendly operating system. So I think that you use the Windows operating system, and on the basis of that, I actually explain what's the minimum requirement of the computer hardware and software. For example, the CPU should be Intel i5 or better, minimum i5 with 2 GHz speed. Intel 6th generation and newer recommended. Because why? Because you know the video, in case of video content, mainly the video content is heavy, much more than the audio content. So if your CPU is not able to process, because only CPU is not involving only processing the your video, CPU also, because Windows is also a multitasking software. So CPU is also involving to do other tasks. So therefore, the minimum requirement for processing the video is Intel i5 with 2 gigahertz speed. And RAM should be 8 GB. Because you know in Windows 10, 4 GB is not sufficient for running the Windows 10 in your machine. So minimum 8 GB is required. And for processing this type of video lectures or preparing this type of video lectures, 8 GB RAM is sufficient. Okay. Now, another thing is important. This is GPU, graphics processing unit, GPU. Modern computer in video card contains a GPU. GPU, you know that the GPU actually mainly responsible for processing the graphics file. They are actually dedicatedly, they are involving for processing the graphics file, not other tasks. So CPU can now involve to process the other tasks, and GPU can now involve process the video content. So it is recommended that whenever you want to process or you want to develop some video lectures, so you have to use the GPU, for example, NVIDIA. You know NVIDIA graphics, NVIDIA or GeForce, GTX 700 or later. AMD also, AMD developed one RDNA GPU series. This is very effective. So you can just incorporate or you can install the GPU in your computer. Okay. And now ultimate thing is that hard disk drive, HDD. 10 GB free hard disk drive space is required minimum, but SSD, we recommended SSD. Why solid state device? Because this is because in case of hard disk, you know that the hard disk is a mechanical device where number of platters, number of read write heads are there. So whenever you want to store something, whenever you retrieve something, you have to your hard disk platter have to move, or the hammer, that read write head also move. It creates a mechanical noise and mechanical some energy, actually they utilize some energy. And whenever you use the SSD, it actually use the flash memory. There is no requirement of movement of any mechanical device. So less amount actually energy will be required. So in case of graphics handling purpose, what do we recommend? We recommended that you have to use the solid state device, SSD device. Okay. This is the minimum requirement. And of course, the operating system is Windows 10. Okay. So this is the minimum requirement. Again, I just gave you the details in nutshell that the CPU minimum is Intel i5 with 2 gigahertz, RAM minimum 8 GB, GPU, NVIDIA or GeForce, GTX 700 or later, and hard disk drive. 10 GB is recommended, but we insist that you have to use the SSD. Now, what hardware actually required for the audio system? Because whenever you capture the sound, you understand that the sound should be clear. And if you can use different software to enhance the quality of sound, but if lot of noise are there, it is too difficult to remove this noise, because what type of software I will show, this is not the very effective software or very costly software for removing this type of noise, because if this is a freely available. So what you think or what you remember, that whenever you capture or whenever you record the audio, you have to use a good quality microphone. For example, through your mobile, you can use the audio, that means headphone, and but you know this is a simple actually tool, the microphone that actually available with the mobile device is simple tool, and if noise or anything actually occurs, it captures the noise. Okay, so whenever you prepare, because the headphone actually mainly it is actually developed only for only for mobile, not for your recording or anything else. Okay. Now I just explain, then I will show the what type of device I have, the device, and I will show one by one. And second point is that Soumen Kumar Pathy raised hand, but I will explain later what the question you asked after completion by lectures. Then you can raise your hand. I will give the answer. Okay. Now, second thing is that through the lavalier microphone, this is the important thing. What's the lavalier microphone? What's the advantage? I will show you. Before that, I stop the sharing. Then I will show in front of my laptop camera what the lavalier microphone. And third one is a professional system. If someone is willing to record the sound in better way, he or she can use some professional system. Now I show one by one. Just I stop the screen here and I will show you. The first one is, you know that this is a mobile. Everyone use the headphone, so it is not necessary to explain, but I will show you the lavalier microphone. This is the one type of microphone I used for the lecture purpose. I will show you. This is a very good quality lavalier microphone. Look that. This is the microphone. You can keep in this way. And this is the condenser. Look that, this is the condenser. So you can put the jack in the audio channel of your laptop. And this is the condenser. It is very effective for catching the sound. Also help to reduce the noise. And you see, this is the part and another part of the microphone. You can remove this part. You see, this is the microphone. And whenever I put this jacket on that microphone, it reduces the noise. Okay. So what you get from this device, you get the crystal clear sound. Okay. So another thing is that you can put with the bag, you can get this jack also, so that you can use this jack. Look that, this jack you can use. So you can put this jack inside this, and you can if you have some audio capture device, you can put this jack. Okay, so everything is there. This is freely, this is available in online site. Actually, I have purchased this from Amazon. This is Boya, B-O-Y-A, Boya. Whenever you purchase, you see this hologram is there or not. So which actually for the authenticity of this Boya microphone, this is a lavalier microphone. This is very good microphone we can use. So I think the cost is maximum $600 to $700. You go to Amazon and you will get the details of the Boya, and you see the what's the feedback of that system. So this is the first thing I will show you, that whenever you capture some audio, you can use this lavalier microphone. Even you can put this jack inside your any camera, in your laptop, in your desktop, in your mobile, in your tab, anywhere. So this is a multi-purpose microphone system you can use. Now, if you want to use some professional system, I have that type of professional system I have already purchased. This is known as the PSonus audio system. This is the very good audio system. Actually, I also purchased this system from online. I will show you. This is the box, PSonus box, PSonus box. And inside the box, you will get this type of headphone. This is very effective. Who want to capture some audio in professional way? This is the first thing. Now, you get the condenser mic. Look that. This is a condenser mic. You can put it on the stand and keep the microphone, and you can record your audio. This is a very effective. And you also get this device. Look that this is the multi-channel device. You can put the jack here, and this is the output. You can put microphone here. So what type of audio you capture, you can listen, and you can adjust your volume, your treble, your bass, everything through this system. So this is the PreSonus. Lot of jacks are there, so you can directly. And what the interesting is that this power cord USB power cord is there. So you put the power cord inside your laptop, and it gets the power from your laptop. So no additional power source will be required for running this device. And lot of jacks are there. You can purchase all the jacks from online. Okay, but advantage of the PreSonus is the feedback is very good, and the cost is a little more high, around 20,000. But you can get the support of PreSonus from our Chennai-based organization. In Kolkata, it is not available. Few persons are there. I have talked with them, but they are not quite experienced guy for giving you the support. But you can get directly support from Chennai. Okay, so this is only for professional audio system. And along with this hardware, you will get the software of PreSonus software, so that you can use this software as a digital studio. So your laptop now act as a digital studio. You can get lot of interface, because this software is advanced software you can use, and also the user friendly software. And of course, another important thing is that you will get update frequently from them, because all over the world, if you see different types of FM channels or all over the world, some weather channels, because the in abroad, you know, the person are very much willing to do a lot of things on weather. So they actually develop their own digital studio, digital audio studio, with the help of only this PreSonus system. Only 20,000 they spend, not in rupees, in dollar, and they can develop their own audio channel, audio system, audio studio. Okay, so this is the thing that we can use for only for professional who actually want to improve their sound quality. But I think that for preparing the digital lecture only for student, you can use this simple Boya microphone. Okay, this is a lavalier microphone. Now this is all for the audio system, and now we concentrate on, again I shared the screen, I concentrate on video. Now hardware for video, so you can capture the video or through your mobile. It is easy, but before you use your mobile to capture the video, what's the problem? If you hold the mobile in your hand and try to capture the video, it is not effective. You can use, I will show you what type of device or what type of instrument you can use. Again, I stop the screen, again I show you. Before that, as I explain, what the different source or different hardware for capturing the video. First one is the through your mobile, you can capture the video. Second one is you can use the your digicam. It is available through your digicam, through handycam. And if someone, actually I prepare the slide in such a way that someone, if interested to develop some lectures in professional way, so they can use the DSLR. Okay, so I have all the equipments in my hand, so I will show you again. So first of all, I show that you can use this type of stand. It is very effective. You can put your mobile in this way. You can adjust your clip either horizontally or vertically. You can place your mobile and put, this is the OET substrate is there. So you can put that base stand on your table in front of you, and just click the record button, and you can capture the video. It will be effective. And what is the cost of the professional system? More or less 20,000. You go to the Amazon site, I don't know whether it is available or not. Actually, I purchased that item last year during lockdown period, 2020, October. So I think that now it is available. So you go to the Amazon site and type the Prisonus professional audio system, you will get the details. Okay. Now you can use this stand. It is available in Chandni. It is available online. Maximum cost is 300 to 400, but it is effective because whenever you capture the video with the hand, it is very difficult to place the mobile in fixed way. So you can use this device. Second one is you can use the Digicam. You can use the Digicam also. This is a very effective. I think that each and everyone has some digital system. Digicam is there. You can keep the digital camera on some tripod. I will show you. And you can capture the video. Okay. This is the thing. And you can use your Handycam. You can use your Handycam also. So this Handycam, very effective. You can use the Handycam. You keep it on the stand and you can capture the video. Okay. And if you want to capture the video in professional manner, so you can use the DSLR. Look that DSLR has some good system. So you can keep the DSLR on the tripod. Look that this is the tripod. Okay. Because without using tripod, you are not able to use this system for capturing the good quality video. And you also see that here is a microphone. Look that three dot. This is a powerful microphone. Either you can use the wire directly, put the audio jack here, or you can use this microphone. But what's the problem? This microphone captures the surrounding sound. So whenever you capture the audio or video, simply switch off the power of your fan, AC, etc., etc. I will later explain how you capture the good quality audio or video. Okay. So this is only for professional who can capture the video in professional way. And this is the tripod. It is available with this camera, and you can use the lens. What type of lens you can use, if you want to know, then after the completion of my workshop, you can send me the question. I will give you the answer. So this is the hardware that we can use for capturing video and audio. Now, again, I share the screen. Achha, before I share, again, I explain one thing. I don't know, because more or less 300 people are there, 300 listeners are there. So someone may be in biology domain. So you can, whenever you prepare some attractive slide, attractive content, you can use the digital microscope. I have the digital microscope. Sometimes look that this is a Celestron digital microscope. This is a USB port. So if you want to show something to your student, so you can use this digital microscope. It is only for biology, actually, the who want to develop some slides in the biology or applied biology, then they can use, this is a Celestron microscope, digital microscope, and maximum 600 times you can see through this interface, through this software, because with this Celestron digital microscope, you also get one of the effective software through which you can access, you can see what the micros actually see. So you can incorporate, you can store, you can save that pictures and incorporate into the slide. So your video should be attractive. So this is the thing. Even you can, only for biology purpose, I tell you that you can use this type of dissection. This is a section. Say, you can cut the section. You can, I have everything with my, because this is the device I can use for section different parts of plants. Actually, this is my interest, so I purchase all of all these things and actually prepare my slide and everything. Okay, so you can purchase. This is not costly because Celestron digital microscope maximum 6,000. So if you have interest, you can purchase. So this is the thing that hardware things that you can use. And now I again share the screen and go to the software part. Yes. So this is the hardware for video I explained, and this is my tips that please use tripod during the video recording. Okay. Now I now enter into the main part of my workshop. First one is, suppose you capture the video through your mobile, through your camera, through your DSLR, etc. and etc. You also capture the audio simultaneously. Now, if you incorporate some YouTube video, how it's possible without using the YouTube downloader? Look that this is the URL you can use. Whenever you type or whenever you search something on your YouTube search box, you see that some URL actually appears on the screen. And during that time, you just put SS, cell script, SS in front of the YouTube and press the enter. I will show you. You see that the video automatically download in your computer. Just show you. Look that, suppose this is the YouTube. Suppose I type, what is nanotechnology? Pen, is it visible? Pen, is it visible? Hello?
Yes, it is visible, we continue.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Yes. So what is nanotechnology? If I write in my search box, what is nanotechnology? I see this is the video appears on the screen and this is the URL. I simply put or write SS here and then press enter. Look at the button. Look that it retrieved the URL and download option automatically come. And you click on it. You see that something is downloading and you just close this window. Look that. What is nanotechnology? It is downloading. So it is very simple. You type, you just see, you just type what you want to retrieve or what you want to see. You just type that video link and put the SS in front of the YouTube and press enter. Automatically, it is downloading in your computer. Look that, it is downloading. So this is the simple way by which, without using of any YouTube downloader, third party YouTube downloader, you can use only the SS in front of YouTube link and you will get the details. Okay. So this is the way by which you can see that you can download the software. Now, again, I'll show you. This is a download video from the YouTube that only type ssyoutube.com and this is the URL. So automatically it is downloaded in your computer and then you can take that video from the download section and keep it in other folders. So this is the way by which, without using the any third party downloader, you can use, okay, SS. Now, the second part is the important part. After downloading this video, how will segregate the video and audio? We can use the online free tool, which is known as audioextractor.net. What's the advantage? Audioextractor.net never store your information. It only get the information, segregate the video and audio. You can download and you can use the audio for the future purpose. You simply segregate the audio part from the video and give you the, you can download the video and you can use. So you just remember the URL audioextractor.net. I will explain after giving you the details of the mini tool movie maker, that whenever you get the video and audio, because in video, the video remains the same, but you extract the audio from the video part and you can store the audio part separately in different folder for enhancement the quality of audio or some or in, incorporate something into the audio part. But in video part, you can use the Minitool Movie Maker. What the URL of the Minitool Movie Maker? This is the Minitool Movie Maker URL, https://moviemaker.minitool.com. Okay, so this is the, so after I show you the two steps, two and three steps, I again stop the share screen and open the URL. I type audioextractor.net. Look that it opens and click on open video option. Just 1 minute. Open video option. Here you see that actually this appears from the download. I just copy 1 minute this download section part and then paste here. This is my video, what is nanotechnology. I select it and open. Look that it is uploaded in the audioextractor.net site. And there are different version of the audio format. Generally, we select or we prefer MP3 and WAV format. Okay, so it takes some time because the file is more or less 5 to 6 minutes length. So it takes some time. It extract the audio from the video file in MP3 format. And there is a, after that, you simply click on, yes, now you click on extract audio. Look that, how fast it is. It simply extract and give the download option. You click download off. Automatically it is downloaded in your computer. And now you open, cut it and paste. Look that. It gives the name, what is nanotechnology, same file name with audioextractor.net. You can change the file name also. Okay. Now, if you want to know, if you want to see what's the content of this audio file, you can simply double click on it and you can listen. This is only the audio file. Just say, look that. So this is the audio file. You just download it and you can later modify with the help of Audacity. How? I will explain. Before that, you just enhance the quality of video with the help of Minitool Movie Maker. I already explained what's the source of the Minitool Movie Maker. It is totally freely available, free open source software. So you can use, I just close this window, audio extractor, minimize the window. Again, I share the screen. Look that. I go to desktop, and here I see. Oh. You see, look that. Minitool Movie Maker is there. I just open it.
It is not displaying. It is displaying the folder options.
Folder option, na?
Yeah, tutorial on video preparation.
Okay. Yes, that is. Yes, this is the interface of the Minitool Movie Maker. Okay. So from this interface, you can modify your video frame by frame. Look that this contain the different parts. First, for example, at the topmost ribbon, there is a media, transition, effect, text, and motion. Okay. And the second, the left part, contain the My Album, videos, music, pictures. This is the another panel where you see what you upload in this interface. You see this interface here, and this is the preview window. What you want to do or what you are doing, you see the content here. And at the bottom part, there are a frame by frame analysis part. You see this is the individual frame, and between two frame there is a transition part where you can incorporate different types of effects. How? I will show you. Suppose I want to incorporate the video that I have downloaded to the YouTube. So I go to the import media files. It goes here and I select the folder. Then I select what is nanotechnology and click it. Look that. It appears on the panel. You can see the content of the video by simply place the cursor on it. Look that. This is the video. Simply place the cursor on it and you will see. Now you simply drag it onto this panel. How? You simply click on this plus sign. It comes onto the panel and you see it shows the each and every frame. And this is the sound part and this is the video part. Both parts are there. So you see the work content is more or less 3 minutes 33 seconds. So you can see the what's the content of the video by simply click on it. Look that, this is a time frame. Where your position, it shows the frame by frame. You can stop it. You can simply cut. If you want to remove, you simply cut it. Click on it or delete, or you can put something, some transition frame here. How? If you want to put something here, you simply go to the effect side. Look that, this is a different type of effect. You can insert or you can incorporate into your video, or you can give some transition effect, some burning sensation, some clock voice sensation, etc., etc. If I want to put the burning sensation here, it goes. Just 1 minute. Even I can switch off the audio also. Look that. Here I switch off the audio signal. Simply, it is a toggle feature. You see the video part only. So this is the audio track. So whenever you modify the audio of this video, because you have already extracted the audio part from this video, and with the help of Audacity, you can again I switch off this video, audio part. You can incorporate that audio, modified audio, in this audio track. Okay, look that the video is running without audio. Again, you open, you get the answer. Okay, so you can stop it. You can put something. Suppose if you want to give some text, look that text maybe. Three types, either it is caption, or it is credits, or it is title. Because whenever you prepare the class lecture, there are three types of text. Number one is a caption. If you want to incorporate some captions here, you can put. If you want to, at the end of the lectures, if you give the credit section, so you can select the credit, and you simply add, automatically it goes to the end of your video. And if you want to give some title, you can put, you see that the different types of graphics titles there, you can put this. But if you want to incorporate something different title, how it's possible? Then you have to use your own memory. How? You simply create a one slide in the PowerPoint, you give all the details on it, save it as a MPEG video format, and then upload that format into this Minitool Movie Maker, and then you can incorporate that format into as a title in your site. Okay, so this is the another thing by which we can use your customized title here. Okay, this is the already given, this title are already given. You can put, you can put, look that it comes here. So if you want to put that title here, it goes there. And you simply write something here. You can adjust. Even you can look that. You can see the output. Look that this is the site. Okay. If everything is okay, then click okay. So now the slide, you can also adjust the time second. It shows maximum 6.2 seconds. So with the help of time frame, you can adjust the time frame also. Okay. Now, at the end part, suppose I want to break the video here. So I simply click on this scissor part. Now the video consists of three parts. Number one, title. Number two, this, and number three, this. Look that again, you switch off the audio part. And now if you want to use some transition here, you select the time frame here, goes the transition, and click it here. Okay, now at the end of this session, if you want to put some credits, you can identify what type of credits you want to incorporate or you want to add. Look that if it is quite okay for you, so you simply click on it. Look that it comes, and you can again starting something you write here, enter your name here, etc., etc. Look that you simply type something, write, etc., etc. Okay, you can modify, and if it's okay, you You can check the preview. And if it's okay, then you click on OK. Otherwise, you can reset. So your video, with the help of Minitool Movie Maker, you can incorporate some information. You can cut something. If you want to remove some part of the video, you simply drag the time frame, this time frame, or you can drag here. Look, that time frame automatically goes. And if you want to remove something, frame by frame, you can analyze. If I want to cut this portion, I simply cut. Look that. Now I remove this, right click on it and delete. So that, look that, what's the preview? Okay. So if you see that everything is okay, then you can, just 1 minute. You can, here is a scene, here is a one sign is there, upload portion. You click on this up arrow and it automatically save into MP4 format. I will show you. Suppose if it is okay, then you click on it. Look that, what's the name of the movie? You can give the movie, suppose test. The format is MP4. It is worldwide format, acceptable format. You can change the path, go to the D drive, and where I want to save, I can save. And here I can save it, test MP4. Then I click on export. It takes some time. So it is a quite effective and user-friendly software by which you can cut, you can incorporate, you can add something in your video, and you can save the video. Even you, I just, in this video, you see that I switch off the audio part. I remove the audio part, only the video portion is there. Now I will go to the Audacity and change the video, enhance the quality of video, then again open the test file again and incorporate or add the modified audio into this frame, and then again reconstruct the video. Okay, according to my wish. Even you can see that you can develop, because whenever you give your lecture or prepare your lecture, someone maybe use PC or someone maybe use the mobile device or tab. If you prefer the PC, because automatically it will adjust it by the mobile, so you can select the PC mode. Okay, but if you exclusively want to design for the mobile or tab, you can select this device also. Okay, so in this way we can develop our video format, and Minitool Movie Maker. In Minitool Movie Maker, you will also get some option for template, where you can select the template, you can get the idea, because template, you know, either you can develop your video in your own way, or you can use the template, the predefined option by which you can develop the video. So I just show you the content of the video. You see that there is no sound in the video. So more or less 3 minutes video, it takes 3 minutes, more or less. So roughly you can calculate.
Can we take 2-3 questions, Pritima sir?
Yes.
Live question.
Yes.
We have Shubham Kedia.
Yes.
Shubham Kedia, please unmute your mic. Shubham Kedia. Shubham Kedia. Please unmute your mic. You may direct ask the question. Rohit Kumar Nonia. Rohit Kumar Nonia. Please unmute your mic and you can directly ask. So there is some network issue, I think.
Yeah. Okay.
Yes, sir, they have unmuted. They have unmuted right now. Sir.
Yes.
Shubham Kedia, sir, please. Shubham Kedia, please put your question. Hello. So please carry on.
Okay.
You can take it.
So later. Yeah. So you see that whenever I run the video, look that there is no sound, but the content is, everything is okay. I just show you. So this is the way by which you can modify the video. I just close the interface. Now you see, this is the interface, and here also the motion is there and template is there. You can click on template. You will see lot of templates are there. And according to your selection, you can develop your own video. You can develop your own according to this template. Okay. So this is another thing by which you can develop your video or modify or editing your video. So this is the first thing that I explained, that how with the help of Minitool Movie Maker, you can develop your own video. Now I go to the most important part of the audio section, Audacity. I just close the window. Okay, now I show you again the slide. You just remember the URL, because what's the problem in case of Minitool Movie Maker? Whenever you type Minitool Movie Maker, lot of reference actually come, and you are actually getting puzzled to see which one is the effective site of the Minitool Movie Maker. So better you just note down this URL, https://moviemaker.minitool.com. Okay, whenever you click on this URL, you will get lot of informations, lot of tutorials are there. So you can go through that tutorial and you will get the details of the Minitool Movie Maker. Okay, and I think that you will be able to develop your own video. Now I go to the most important part of our workshop. This is the Audacity. And Audacity, you see that it is a worldwide, it is very effective software, because though it is a free or freely available or open source, but each and every task related to the audio, you can do with the help of Audacity. So note down this URL, https://www.audacityteam.org. So I will show you again the Audacity interface. Just 1 minute. Just 1 minute. Is it visible, Audacity interface? Pen?
No, sir. No, sir. Folder, desktop folder.
Yes, folder here, visible. Okay. Now it is visible. So this is the Audacity part of the Audacity interface. You see, very simple. You just open the audio file. Look that. What is nanotechnology? I extract this audio from the video through audioextractor.net. I select it and open. Look that. Even I can run. Okay, so I can enhance. Look that this is the Audacity panel. At the left part, you see this is the actually audio file. You can segregate the audio file into left and right channel, because whenever you say something or whenever you listen something, your left and right ear actually accept the sound. Like this, you can segregate or you can differentiate the sound into two parts, left channel and right channel. Okay. And then you can, how it's possible, you simply select on it and split the stereo track. Look that. Now it is separate, the left channel and the right channel. Okay. Now you can either you simply just stop or switch off this left channel, only right channel will be active, or you can stop the right channel, only the left channel will be active. So I simply split both the left and right channel, because after that, whenever you create the MP3 file, you again add the both the right and left channel. Okay. So now I enhance the quality, or I want to inspect the what the content of the Audacity file, of this audio file. You see there is a zoom in portion. Suppose I want to know what's the part of this. I just select it, only the left portion, I can zoom it. Look that, I can see. If I want to remove something, I can remove. Look that. If I want to see that I want to remove this portion, I can simply select and delete. Okay. So this is user-friendly software. User-friendly software. Even if you want to remove something from your right channel, you select it, select on it, and you simply press the delete. Okay. Again, if you want to go to the normal position, again, you zoom out. Okay, this is the audio file that you extracted from the video, and now I want to do something on it. I want to enhance the quality of the sound. How it's possible? First of all, suppose this is the monotrack sound. I want to give some stereo effect on this audio file. How it's possible? Because there are a lot of functions are there. You will go through, because only the one class, it is not possible to explain all these things. You will get lot of manuals, lot of support, community initiative of Audacity on the net. So you will go through that. But before that, what's the point that I want to explain? That whenever you capture some sound through your mobile phone, through your own microphone, some noise actually appears. So you want to enhance the quality of sound. For example, in case of video, with the help of Movie Maker, you enhance the quality. In Audacity, we can also enhance the quality of sound from mono to stereo. How it's possible? Just check or just see that what I do. Look that this is the two channel, left channel and right channel. I want to enhance the quality of that. So before I want to do, if I want to enhance the quality of left channel, I have to select it. Just simply double click on it. It automatically selected. And I go to the effect portion, and there are a lot of functions are there. You can amplify, you can change the bass and treble, you can change the pitch, you can change the speed. Even there is a preview options are there. So you click on preview and see what's the effect. And you even you can fade in or fade out. Whenever some actually at the end of the video, actually you can add the fade in option or fade out option. Okay, what you want to do? Even you can remove the noise. Noise reduction is there. Signal noise ratio is there. You can use the signal noise ratio. You can change the noise. Everything is there. You can normalize. With the help of normalize factor, you can normalize. Even you can repair the quality of sound. Reverb, you can add. You simply click on it and you can do a lot of things. Okay, now I first want to, what I want to do? I want to amplify. I reduce the amplify, both the right channel and left channel. How it's possible? I select on it and I select both on it. Okay. Now I go to the effect and there is amplify and I select it. Look that what's the predefined amplify of the audio file is 1.375. But whenever you want to improve or enhance the quality from mono to stereo, remember it should be in negative value. So it should be -3. Automatically, a peak amplitude also change. Okay. Now you click on the preview push option and you understand what's the quality of sound. Okay. If it is okay, then you simply click on okay. Look that something happened on the screen. Okay. Now if you just play the sound, you see some effect actually appears because I reduce the amplification. I reduce the amplify, negative amplifications. Okay, now I stop it. Now I want to change each and individual part of the left channel and right channel. It is very easy. How it's possible? I just select on the left channel part, go to the effect, and look that there is a high pass filter. You just note down the step because whenever you record something, your sound is in mono. So if you want to give some stereo effect, so you have to do this option. So first of all, what you do? First of all, you simply segregate or simply break or split the audio track into two parts. Simply click on it and you can check that there is an option, split audio track. You select on it and now you will get the both the left and right channel. Now you select all left and right channel and reduce the amplification to negative value -3. Now I select on the left channel part and click on the high pass filter. Give the option high pass filter frequency is 100 and roll of dB per octave is 48 and click OK. Then select the right one, again effect. See that there is a low pass filter is there, low pass filter. You select on it and each the frequency should be 8000 and dB per octave is 6 dB. It is a predefined value for stereo. Now you click on it. So some things actually happen. If you again play the sound, you see some stereo effect actually come. I simply drag it. Okay, now this is the first thing that I change the high pass and low pass filter according to the stereophonic sound. So what I do, I simply click the left channel and go to the effect, then high pass filter and give the values and click on okay. And again, click on the right channel, low pass filter and give the value and again, okay. Now I want to give the reverb effect of left channel and right channel. So how it's possible? Again, I select, go to the effect, then reverb. Look that either you can do manually, you can change, etc., etc. You can simply drag or drag on each and every parts of the river portion, or you go to the manage, then factory preset, and select on vocal one. It automatically select, because in manage section, you see lot of factory sets are there. Vocal one, vocal two, bathroom. If I want to, if I sing a song inside a bathroom, you what type of noise, what type of sound I get, I can simulate this type of sound here also. Whenever I click on bathroom, even I can use the small room bright, small room dark, etc. Different types of options are there. You can select and you can check. Actually, the vocal one is more effective. Even with the help of Audacity, you can extract only the vocal part of the music. For example, if you want to retrieve or you want to extract the vocal part of Hemanta Mukherjee's song, you can remove the music part, only the vocal part you can extract with the help of Audacity. Okay, the vocal one and vocal two actually is really help in this regard. Okay, so this is the first part. I change the left channel and click on OK. And then again, right channel, again reverb, go to the manage, factory preset, and select vocal two, and then press OK. Look, something actually happened. And now you just click on play button to see some more stereo effect actually appears. Okay. Now, this is the sound. Now, what I want to do, I want to incorporate another track, another musical track, background music, because whenever you prepare your lecture, you see, whenever someone actually says something, there is a music at background. So background music is the integral part of the video lectures. So how it's possible? You can add, there are different options at the top of the screen. You click on track, add new track. There is a mono track, stereo track, as you have already converted your track to stereo. So I select the stereo track. Look there, this is a stereo track. Now I can put the other track here. How? I just show you. Just 1 minute, I collect the information. Just 1 minute, motivational background. And detest, okay, fine. So I open the another Audacity interface. Open the motivational background I previously stored into this folder. Look that, this is the sound. I think that if it is a background music, I have to reduce the amplification. So again, I select it. Go to the amplify effect, go to the amplify and reduce the amplify section in negative value and see the preview. Yes, it is quite good as a background music. So I stop it, then press it, click OK. Look that, what's the after reduce the amplification, what's the output? Now I know that my main music is 3 minutes 33 seconds long, but here it is more or less 3 minutes. So I select all and Control C, then I select my previous window, select this one and paste it. Look that some problems actually occurs. Why? Thus here 3 minutes 30 seconds. The main audio file is 3 minutes 30 seconds, but the background music is more or less 2 minutes 30 seconds. So I simply again copy this one, suppose this portion, and I again paste it. go there and paste it. Again, I see that something actually happened. So again, I select it here and paste it. Look that the main music ends at 3:30, but now the background music still 4. So I select again and go to this portion and simply delete. Now, if I want to fade in this portion, I select this, then go to the effect and fade out. Look that gradually the sound will decrease. Okay. Now I just listen what's the output of my modified song. Look that this is the background. Okay, so this is a background music. Now I stop. I think that it is okay for me. As I incorporate my background music and there is a foreground versions is there, background is a music. Now I convert all the files into MP3. How? Go to the file, go to the export, export as MP3. Where I want to save? I want to save my desired folder. D drive. This is the, I just put it, what is nanotechnology with background. I just give the name for my understanding with background. Okay, it is MP3 file. I save it. It gives one information, your tracks will be mixed down and exported as one stereo file. That means what I want to do, I want to convert my mono into stereo. Audacity automatically explains, automatically shows that my conversion is right, proper way. So it gives the information, your tracks will be mixed down and exported as one stereo file. I click OK. Now it shows one window where you can put your name. For example, here I put it automatically embedded into the audio file. See, for example, in future, if anyone want to retrieve or want to pirate this item, it actually, it is not possible because already the artist name MacOut will be embedded into the modified audio file. Okay, so I click on OK. Now, it is exporting audio with a standard MP3 file. Clear? Now I simply close it or minimize it. Now if I want to play this one with background, look that this is MP3 format. I simply drag. Okay, now the final portion that I want to reconstruct the video again, because what the video I have made, there is no sound. Now I incorporate or add this sound into this video. Again, I open the Minitool Movie Maker. Okay, now this is the, I incorporate or I upload.
It is not displayed.
Screen is not. Okay. Forget. Yeah, again, I show you. Yes. Now I again import the media file. What the media file? What is nanotechnology? This one. What is nanotechnology? I simply put it. Oh my God, this is not what is nanotechnology. Oh, test one, sorry. I simply import the test one file. I remove this one. So I simply select and delete. Okay, now I import the test file. Look that, this is my media file, video file, which have no sound. Now I import the audio file with the background. This one. This is the audio file. Look that, I simply place the cursor on it. I listen, yes, it is. Now I simply click on it, the at sign, it automatically goes to the audio track. Even I can see what actually happened. Look that, everything is good. So if I want to adjust, look that, the end of the video file and end of the audio file, there is a difference. So I can drag the audio file, select on it, I simply drag it, okay? And see, yes, now it's okay. Now whenever, look that, automatically the time frame also change, okay? Now if I want to run this modify audio file, what's the content?
Audio part is not coming.
Audio part, no?
Yeah. Audio part is not.
Okay. I will let her show you. So this is the actually this is the output of the video. Then I export. Final video, and save it in my desired folder. Final video 1.1, because whenever you prepare the video, you have to give the version number, because if anything change, you can check what the version number is. Oh, already exists, sorry, 1.2. Final video 1.2. Okay. Now I click on export. So with the help of Minitool Movie Maker and Audacity, you can change the audio. You can enhance the audio. You can enhance the video quality. You can reconstruct the video. But again, some problem is there. If I want to put the logo in my video, how it's possible? There is no scope if I use the Minitool Movie Maker, because the Minitool Movie Maker can only do frame by frame analysis, but if you want to put some extra features on it, it is not possible. So in that case, what can we do? So after the completion of video, we can take the video, we can open the video or insert the video into the Microsoft PowerPoint. And then I can insert the logo. I can take the logo and I can insert the logo on it. And then again, save as it as a MP4. So your video now contains the logo of your university or college. I'll show you after the completion of that, I'll show you how you can incorporate on not only the video, not only the logo, also some text option, also some caption, also etc. etc. You, if you want to put, you can do in this way. Just wait for a few minutes, or 1 minute maximum. You can change the resolution also, but what we prefer, 1920x1080 is the effective resolution of any video, because it maintains the aspect ratio. You know that whenever you see a video on your screen, it should maintain the aspect ratio. So 1920x1080 is effective for maintaining the all type of aspect ratio of any video device. If you want to see the content on your TV, on your smart TV, on your mobile, on your laptop, on your desktop. So 1920x1080 is sufficient for maintaining the aspect ratio. So we prefer normally it, but if you want to change, you go to the setting part and you can change. Okay, look that the size is minimum 216 MB. You can easily upload that information in the YouTube, or you can easily stream the information. Okay, so I close it. Look that final video 1.2 is my video. Now I open the Microsoft PowerPoint. Is it visible? Yes. Is it visible now?
Yes, sir. PPT is visible.
Yes. Now I can insert. I can insert the video here. I can insert the video. Just 1 minute. Look that video. Actually, lot of screens actually open. Therefore, this problem actually occurs. This is the video option in insert. And this device, from this device, I select the video from my folder. This is the 1.2 is my video. Insert this video here. Now I want to incorporate or add the logo of my university. This device. Presentation on 1st July, here I maintain the logo, insert. I put it here, adjust it. Even I can give the effects also. Look that effects. Even I can add the text also, everything you can add here. And now you just see the bottom part of the PowerPoint. Now I save it. I save as this PC. Again, go to the presentation, not presentation. I give the, select the MP4 and final video 1.3. Final video 1.3. Okay. Now it is MP4. Save it. Look that at the bottom part. Creating video, final video 1.3 takes some time because each and every frame, Microsoft PowerPoint take the responsibility to insert the logo of our university in each and every frame. If you want to incorporate some text here, you can write the text and convert it into the MP4. It takes sometimes more or less 3 to 5 minutes it takes, depending on the speed of your processor, speed of your GPU, and speed of your CPU. Because the whole task is segregated into two parts. First part, they incorporate the logo into the video part. They actually, the video file is processed by the GPU and along with the CPU also assist. So it takes some time because a lot of process is are going on. So it takes some time. Look that it more or less 3 to 5 minutes. After that, the everything will be ready. So this is the way by which we can incorporate the desired input or desired text or desired pictures or desired logo into my movie without using any other types of software with the help of Microsoft PowerPoint. Remember, it should be saved in MP4 format. Okay. So, okay, now I share the, I minimize this window. After the completion, I will show you what's the output. Okay. Now, again, I go to the slideshow. Again, I go to the slideshow. So, working with Audacity, complete. Reconstruct the video. Reconstruct video with Minitool Movie Maker, complete. Working with Microsoft PowerPoint for reconstructing video. When, why, and how, already I have explained. Now I go to the one of the important part, the transcription by author. You know that whenever you use the Google, mainly the author file actually transcript what you say. Suppose I want to change the voice of the female in my video to male. How is it possible? I want to change. You know that the video actually contained the voice of female, but I want to change the female voice to male voice. How it's possible? I can use my memory and then I can do these things very efficiently. How? With the help of the author, I can change, I can retrieve the information, the content of the video and convert it to the text. Then I can use one of the AI-based software, text to speech again. And there I can use the male voice. Again, I just modify the voice section and incorporate that voice into Movie Maker tool. And then again, reconstruct the video. At later stage, at the end of the session, I will show you. This is quite interesting. What the content of video, the content is actually in female mode, I can change to the male voice. Okay, look that. So I now explain how with the help of the author, you can do the transcription process. You just remember what's the URL of the author, https://author.ai. To access the author, you have to log in through your Google mail ID, Gmail ID, okay? And what's the advantage of the author? You can do the transcription of the video maximum 10 hours in a month. Again, I explain that with the help of the author, you can convert your speech to text of a video maximum 10 hours. So 10 hours video, you can convert to text. So how? I will show you. I just auto login. Is it visible, Pen?
Water is not visible, sir. Sir, yes. I have messaged you. Please check it once again.
Okay. Yes, now it is visible. Look that.
Yes.
Now it is visible, yes. Look that. This is the interface of the Otter. I simply type the Otter AI and log in through the Google, my Gmail ID. And you see that this is my account. 596 minutes left. 28 days. After 28 days, again, it will again recharge with 600 minutes. Free. Basic free, totally free. I think this is sufficient for making the video tutorial for our students. 600 minutes, that means 10 hours, 1 month is sufficient. So there is no need to purchase anything. It is totally free. Now, how I can do that? I click on import. Browse the file. From where I want to get the information. So this is the, what is nanotechnology? This is the file, what is nanotechnology? This audio file contain music as well as the voice. Look that this software is quite intelligent. It can segregate the music part and only transcribe the voice part. Look that. I click on what is nanotechnology part, or I can click on what is nanotechnology background. This is more effective. It takes some time to upload in the cloud. Okay. Now I click on, it shows the message import success. Now I click done. It takes some time because I go to my conversion. Look that. What is nanotechnology background? It is still processing. It takes some time, 2 to maximum 3 minutes. And then it simply segregate the voice portion first, remove the music portion, give the timestamp. I will show you, give the timestamp and then the transcript, the content. You see the minimum error actually occurs. After the conversion, it gives the confirmation message to your mail through which you actually log in into this system to get the confirmation message from Otter. Yeah, I will definitely give the answer of two participant raise hand after the completion of my lectures. Just give look that it takes maximum 1 minute more. And then, yes, complete. Look that how efficiently it segregates the information. Look that. I click on it, it shows the information. This is the 0.32, that means first 32 seconds, there is a music in the file. So it simply remove. Then from 32 seconds, the conversion actually start. Hey, do you know what the nano means? Now, if you want to export this content, this is the content of your video file, of your audio file, okay? Now, if you want to export, you simply click on it, export the text. Look that, it convert to the text file. It put the unknown speaker because the Otter don't know who is the speaker. So it put unknown speaker. Now you click continue. If everything is okay, now you click on continue. Look that, the text file actually appears. I click on it. You see the unknown speaker, you see the unknown speaker. Hey, unknown speaker, what's the content? Look that. So everything is there. So you simply copy and you can you can put it in a Word file. I share. Look that. This is the content of the your file, content of the audio file. Unknown speaker. Hey, do you know what the nano means? It means small, very small. It is a million times smaller than the everything. Look that. There is no error. There is no error. Look that. A few errors are there. So this is the way by which you can convert the content of your video file to text mode. How it's possible? You simply extract the audio with the audioextractor.net and then put the file into the author and you will get the text file. Okay. Now, if I want to convert the voice to mail, how it's possible? I just show you. I just copy it. I simply remove the unknown speaker. Suppose I remove the unknown speaker, it's not possible to actually the time constraints is there. So I simply remove some unknown speaker and simply copy it. Now I go to the another interface, AI based interface. I will show you. Again, I share. This is the one of the AI interface where I put the content. I don't know whether you listen or not. If I speak,
do you know what nano is? It is small, very small. It is really not small, but it's small as measure of it. If you want to get it up here, small and nano, it is
small. Look that. So you can convert. You can convert the file to the MP4 and then you incorporate or add the MP4 file into Movie Maker in video panel. Okay, now simply the voice actually converted to the mail. Okay, in this way, we can change everything to the video. So this is the important part that I explain. Actually, in the meantime, I just see whether Yes. 1.3 MP4. Yes. Look that. I just hold. Again, I share the screen. This is the modified video. Look that at the top right corner, there is a MacOut logo.
Sound is not coming pretty
much. Yeah, sound is not coming. I don't know why. Yeah, okay, that's not a problem.
At the time of sharing only, you have to choose the sound option at the bottom.
Okay. Coming. A lot of screen I have shared. Look that. Now sound is coming?
No, sir.
No?
No, sir. Says you stop the sharing and while you share, you have to click at the bottom there is share sound also.
Share sound. Yes, I click it. Share sound. Yeah, just 1 minute. Again.
The bottom left side.
Again, I share it. And just 1 minute. Just give me 1 minute. Where is the content? Yes, Yes, content share sound. Now I share it again. Sound come?
Yes, sir. It is very low, but it is coming, sir.
Very low. Look, there is a topmost, right topmost corner, there is a UTEC logo.
Hey, do you know what nano means? It means small, very small.
Okay, fine.
It is
so
a million times smaller than the smallest measure on a ruler.
Close it. Okay, now I again share the, because I know that from 7:30 another program will start. So there are two things that I have to explain again. Just 1 minute. Yes. Look that. So from transcription by author, I have already explained how it's how you can do. Now the important part is working with graphics. So you just note down the following URL: https://school.nawmal.com, nawmal.com. This is a very good medium, graphics medium, AI-based graphics medium, by which you can develop your own graphics environment, where you can incorporate, where can you can add lot of animated icons or animated things, so that you can simulate the class environment. Just I show you one video, I will show you the video. 1 minute. You can see, yes, you can see that I developed that video with the help of this tool. Just 1 minute. Look that. Sound is coming, na, ma'am?
Welcome to Maulana Abul
Kalam, yes, sir. Yes.
University of Technology, West Bengal. Makat, WB. Today we will discuss about the online digital lecture. Welcome to our online digital tutorial. It is attractive and interesting. We expect your involvement and active initiative in this subject. Today, Professor A. Mukherjee of Computer Science Department, Makat, WB will take the class. I hope you have fun using this interactive tutorial and don't hesitate to contact us via support if you have any questions, to share your stories or give us feedback to our university mail. Let's enjoy. Hi. My name is Professor A. Mukherjee, Associate Professor of Computer Science Department, Makat, WB. Today I am taking online class on online tutorial video, but before we start, Mr. Rahul is here, who show the animation.
Thank you, Professor Mukherjee. Welcome to all. My name is Mr. Rahul. I show you one animation.
So, okay, so this way I just developed the environment. How it's possible, I just show you. I just open one screen here. Give me 1 minute. I just open. We just download the system. It is only developed only for education purpose. So look that, this is the normal Edu. This is the screen. I just show you new project. Whenever you sign in and everything, the normal process, whenever you do all the normal process, then this screen actually appears. New project, click on new project. You select any ambience, for example, reception room. Suppose I create the reception room and click on OK. It takes some time for retrieve the information from the cloud and incorporate all these things in your graphical medium. And after that, you will get this environment. And there are two types of camera option is there. This camera, you click and you can move here and there. What position you want to choose, you can put it here. Suppose I do it, then again click on it. I zoom it. Okay. Now I want to put someone, some characters here. So I click on this one and I put it here. Look that. That character actually appears on the screen. Yeah. Change the character. Change the character. I want put it this. Okay, now if look that the character actually appears. This is the front position. I place it in such a way. You can put another character here. If he is a teacher, you can put the student here also. And this is the panel where I can add line. Look that. Hi. I just space, give some space. I am a sen. Then again, add line, give some pause here. Again, I add line and I give, how are you? Now, if I click on this,
I am a sen. How are you?
It can say, okay. So in this way, you can create your own file, own simulation environment. So you can put the character, you can train the system in your own way. You can change the position of that person. Everything you can do. After that, you just go there and you just export movie. Select that movie name is Test One Movie. Animated movie, sorry. Animated movie. MP4 and the tutorial video presentation. Then I click on export. So you can, in this way, you can create your own environment because it is a very user-friendly software. You can go through the system and you will get everything. We will get a lot of community tutorials from internet. So if you now check the movie part, you will see, look that. Animated movie.
I am a fan.
Just 1 minute, I'll share it. Look that, this is my movie. Look that. You can lot of text you can put, you can create a lot of conversation, and in this way you can create the video image file, movie file, and then you can incorporate that movie file in your lectures. Okay. So this is the another way by which you can create a lot of graphics tools. I just remember the URL and you will go through the site and you will get the details. Now the last portion that I have to explain, this is the OBS. This is the OBS part. This is the most important part of the system. OBS part, where you actually, you know, whenever we develop the lectures, it may be offline or online. If you want to broadcast the online lectures through the system, through the Facebook or WhatsApp, through the YouTube, you can use some broadcasting software, but more or less you find that from the net, you get the all the broadcasting software are costly, but OBS is totally free. And this is the URL. You can download the OBS from internet. The site is https://obsproject.com/download. You can download the OBS site, and I will show you. Before that, I just give the rest of the slide. Then I will show you the OBS at last. Whenever you give, whenever you broadcast something, some lectures and some things you want to broadcast, it is live.
Okay, sir, so, we are running out of time, yes, sir, please.
Yeah, I want to stop my lecture within 5 to 6 minutes. Okay. So this is the point you have to remember. Be comfortable with social media. Engage with your audience. Don't take yourself too seriously, because it is live. There is no option for rectify yourself later in offline mode. Ensure you will be researched and prepared. Have a specific goals. Ignore your viewers count, because it is the main point. Whenever we give some online lectures or online tutorials, we want to see how many actually present. So this is ignore your viewer count. Reduce the number of the scenes and sources. This is the main point. Because in OBS, you can add a lot of cameras, a lot of windows. So you simply reduce the camera to one or two, okay? And keep yourself up to date. This point you have to remember when you broadcast something, okay? And now how to reduce the noise during the recording, you just remember that you place the microphone in front of your mouth so that the distance between your mouth and microphone should be minimum. Therefore, you see in different types of musical show, you see that the singer actually plays the microphone to close their mouth. Okay. Now, eliminate the background noise. This is the main point. Because whenever some ACs switch on or the fan is moving, then the sound actually, the mic actually, microphone actually catches the sound. Okay. Some husky sound actually appears, background noise, as a background noise. Then reduce the traffic noise. Suppose if you just create a lectures in your room, at the roadside, some traffic noise actually comes. Simply you remove that place and go another side, because the traffic noise take some pitch sound, it easily inserted into your video and get a lot of noise. Now, how to enhance the video quality? You just remember this, there are different types of software, open source software, free software is available. After the movie maker, Minitel movie maker, you can use the Filmora. Filmora is a very good software, but what's the problem? What's the limitation is that in Filmora, you actually free version, the watermark actually incorporated in your video. But you, if you use the power detector or AvidMax or InShot, it is Android or Windows version is there, you can use freely. Okay. Now I show you the last one, the OBS one. I have 8 minutes in my hand. So I just show you the OBS one. After download the OBS, you just see OBS Studio. This is a broadcasting studio. I just show one thing, that whenever you see some video lectures, you see, just I share the screen. Yes. This is a broadcasting interface, you see. And here the panel is there. What the video lecture, what you see in case of Udemy or in case of Coursera, you see that the inset, some the person who actually giving the lecture, the inset, he is present at the inset at the top rightmost corner or top right leftmost corner, and that the background, some slideshow is going on. Okay, so how it's possible? So before you create that. This is the open interface of the OBS. I remove this existing one. Just I remove the existing one. What's the procedure? I just show you. This is the initial interface of the OBS broadcaster. And you first open the PPT, what you want to show at the background. Suppose I click on the PPT's site. I suppose want to show the Center for Precision Farming site. It is very important that what PPT you want to show, you just go to the, open the first open, then you go to the slideshow, and then click on frame. Is it visible?
No, sir.
Okay.
It is a black screen.
Yes. Now, is it visible now? Go to the slideshow, set up the slideshow.
PPT is visible.
Yes, PPT. Set up the slideshow. Now click on the browse by the individual window and click on OK. Okay, now you click from beginning. Your slideshow, before you start to broadcast your slideshow, you simply open the slide, go to the slideshow settings and select that radio button and click on the slideshow button. Then you click the OBS. Is it visible now?
OBS is not visible.
Okay. Again, yes, now it is visible. So now you click the scene first at the bottommost corner. You suppose my scene is new scene. New scene. Okay. Now I go to the source area where I click the video source, video capture device. Now my laptop camera is there. So I give the video capture device name 1 and put it. It is not visible as that it is captured by the zoom. So I just turn off the camera, stop video. Now it will be visible. Yes, look that, it is now visible. I just adjust the window in this way. Now I add the window capture. Window capture is suppose WC1. Okay, from that window capture, I actually select the Microsoft PowerPoint. Look that, it comes. Now I adjust. Okay. It is simultaneously working with both the interface, in my PPT interface as well as in my OBS interface. Now at the right side, there is several options is there. Start streaming. Start streaming means whenever you click on it, you get some URL. This URL you can put in your Facebook so that the Facebook can live streaming your presentation. Or you can click on the start recording. So if you click on the start recording, it automatically records what you want to say. And if you go to the slideshow and simply drag it, it can show, as it is here, it can show the output. Okay, it can show the output. Then what type of output you want to see, it can show the output automatically, it is recorded. And after that, you click on the stop recording. Okay, now, so through this OBS, either you can streaming the information through the Facebook, simply click the streaming and get the URL and just put the URL in your Facebook Live. Automatically it's streaming. And if you want to record something, you just simply on start recording. At the background, the whatever you want to show, you can see. Even you can add the different source of cameras and you can put the cameras in this way and select one by one. In this way, because OBS is the vast, if I get the opportunity in future to explain more, I can explain more about on Audacity and OBS. It is not a one day for single minutes, 1 to 3 minutes for explaining all these things. Just I show you, you can go through the system. I think that from 7:30, another session will be started. So I end this session now, and if any questions you can ask them.
You stop your screen sharing.
Yes.
I think the questions and all these things, Pritima, you can give your email address and phone numbers in the chat box so that all those are interested to know more, you know, this about these things in a deeper manner. They can contact you.
Yes.
So this is one thing. Secondly, this is just an initiation, and we will be organizing these types of workshop in near future further. We will be announcing that very soon. And those who have joined, they will get their certificate. For certificates and all these things, they contact these, they use this feedback link as provided by our digital, you know, this executive. So with this, I believe that something you have learned from out of this exercise, and hopefully you will try to implement all this knowledge for making your digital content more engaging and attractive. So thank you for attending this program. We will be conducting the next round very soon, and you will be informed. Thank you. Stay safe always. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. And thank you all. My mail ID is pritimoy.shannal@gmail.com. You can send your question. I will try to give the answer.